The second annual Uganda Farm and Healthcare Expo that started yesterday at Uganda Manufacturers Association, UMA Exhibition Hall, has attracted over 100 pharmaceutical manufacturers and suppliers from within and out of the country, more specifically from India. Officiating the expo, the Minister of State for Primary Healthcare, Margaret Muhanga, noted that whereas the country has made some progress in developing the local pharmaceutical sector, it is still very slow. She appealed to foreign pharmaceutical companies to invest in Uganda to enable the cost of pharmaceutical products to be reduced.
Uganda right now has got 6 factories which produce medicines, including ARVs, and supplies in the region. But also we have about 20 smaller manufacturing companies. We also have a lot of scientists right now who are doing research on manufacturing our own drugs, and especially herbal drugs that has less effect on our body organs.
Muhanga further notes that the country imports over 80% of the therapeutics, human and veterinary drugs and medical equipment. And according to the Minister of Finance, this accounts to over 1 trillion shillings spent every year. However, this can be reduced by more than a half once these items are produced locally.
I'll give myself as an example. I passed sciences very well when I was in O-level. But I didn't do sciences because I thought it was wasting too much time staying in school for too long. And I wanted a quick way out. I went to study mass communication. I should have done something else. I should have gone for medicine. But I feared that it would take me forever to finish school. So it's now motivating young people. When government takes a bold stand, it's motivating many young people to study sciences right now, so that we can develop. Science develops people, but not
knowing very well that we have only up to 10% capacity to manufacture medicines. We thought that an exhibition of this nature, where we have the experts from India in manufacturing of medicines, pharmaceuticals, health supplies, equipment, and many other areas of products, would come here first to showcase what they are making.
Speaking at the same event, Mr. Ajay Kumar, the Indian High Commissioner to Uganda, revealed that the Indian government will work closely with the Ugandan business community to establish a strong pharmaceutical sector in Uganda.
You know, medicine is the most inelastic product. People have no option but to buy. Whatever price you can bought, they have no option but to buy. And I don't want to name, but certain nations, certain industries from certain countries, they have been selling drugs at an exorbitant cost until India became a major player in this area.
At the expo, various companies and institutions are showcasing various items such as personal protective gear, medical gas and its equipment, among other items.
We are so excited to come and be part of the international exhibition on pharmaceutics, pharmacy training and related activities.
Report compiled by Rachel Nachuala for the news.